Gilbert Gottfried, and this is Gilbert and Frank's Amazing Colossal Obsessions with my co-host Frank Santopadre, once again at Nutmeg with our engineer Frank Verderosa. And our guest is Mario Cantone.
We kept Mario around. He was here for a Christmas episode.
Yes, which will be on the air very soon.
Yes, and we wanted to do a little mini episode about Christmas music.
It's mini. It's mini.
We do these little 15-minute jobs.
What kind of a job?
Tell me.
What? You know, I need to talk about my Christmas as Liza Minnelli. When I was 6 years old, I was in front of the fireplace waiting for Santa with a stack of cookies and a novel by Dostoevsky. I was reading this novel, and I fell asleep. And when I woke up, the cookies were gone. And I said, Santa came, and he ate the cookies. But then I remembered I took an Ambien, and I sleeping. Mama gave me the Ambien, I guess.
That's so wrong.
No, it's true.
Now, Christmas is very important to you, as we established in the last episode.
It is.
You grew up in Stoneham, Mass.
Yeah, I did. Yeah.
What were your Christmases like?
Well, we had a silver tree. It was a silver. It was a.
Did you have a tree with a color wheel?
No.
We had that.
We had a color wheel for a while. Then my mother got rid of it. But we never had a green tree and never had a real tree. It had a silver stick and you plugged in these silver looked like tinfoil that was all shredded.
They were big then.
Yeah, I mean, and then red balls. It was the worst Christmas tree.
Do you have Super 8 footage of this tree? Do you have evidence?
I think I might have pictures.
We had the color
it.
Wheel growing up in Ozone Park in Queens. We had the silver foil tree and there was a wheel with a light behind it with a single bulb. And there were four colors on the wheel. And when the wheel turned, the tree turned different colors.
Yes, absolutely.
Really ghastly business. It turned orange and red and green and blue.
Was it a silver? It was a silver tree?
Silver foil tree.
Oh, yeah. Brutal.
Yeah, it was like tinsel, the tinsel material in tree form.
And you couldn't use tinsel on the tree because it was already there. It would just disappear.
Right.
They were terrible. But, you know, I got what I wanted. I was a spoiled brat. My mother never said I love you, but she would give me things. That's why if you give me something, you love me. That's how fucked up I am. I remember the big Walt Disney book, the Art of Walt Disney by Christopher Finch. It was like, the book was like.
I know that book.
Oh, it's a huge book. Yeah. It looked like one of the books at the beginning of the animation, you know, one of the animated movies that opened up. They were huge. The Disney films, I had Disney. I was Disney Fag Friday. I was like, I loved it. I loved all that stuff. I had ceramics and I got anything I wanted. I was a brat. And we were just middle class. You know, we weren't rich. My father was a bookie and my mother was a bookie and a compulsive gambler. Wow.
That's a good combo. Yeah. But the Christmas was important to the Cantones.
Yeah, it was. My mother would cook, but it was, she hated it. You know, and now that she's dead, I know, it's a project. You do the seven fishes every Christmas Eve, the big shrimp and the bacala and the bacalao.
Why do they still do that, the seven fishes?
I do it.
You do?
I do it.
You do, you and Jerry?
I carry on the tradition.
That's nice.
My husband, my African-American husband, makes all the seven fishes. He makes the baked stuffed shrimp. He makes the bacala.
Wow.
The motherfucker makes bacala.
Wow.
My mother never made bacala.
I'm coming
my
over.
Aunt did. Oh, he makes a great bacala. He does a great job. And then I'll do the desserts. And then on Christmas, I make lasagna with gravy and meatballs. I do that. You know, that's what we do. I don't, and Thanksgiving, who the fuck wants turkey?
Right.
We make lasagna shaped like turkey with a little rigatoni.
I remember your bit about Thanksgiving with the uncle with the gnocchi ring.
Yeah, he had the gnocchi ring.
Right.
Yeah, and he would sip. They would always be watching you know, it was before picture in a picture. So they had the orange bowl and the Super Bowl and your mother's bowl and the toilet bowl, every fucking bowl, because they were booking. They were all booking.
Right, right, right.
And I would hear my Uncle Philly, with the hand down the pants and the pinky ring would stay out because it was too fucking bulbous to fit in his pants. And he'd just be like, oh, Jesus Christ, they dropped the fucking ball. I got money on this game. Money on the me. Oh, my God. And I'd be in the other room screaming shut up! I'm trying to watch The Wizard of Oz! And I was.
Gil, I've never asked you about this. You didn't celebrate Christmas in the Gottfried household. What was Christmas like? Was it Jews go to the movies day? Chinese food?
Well, you know, this is really weird.
Because I've always wanted to know.
I can't wait. Go
this
ahead.
Well, I'm not surprised. This is very weird. All of us were Jews. Well, that's the way it is in a family, usually.
Yeah.
And somewhere along the way, we got one of those artificial Christmas trees.
Oh, like the ones we're talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you had a green one. You didn't have a silver one.
It looked like a real tree. Yeah. It was green.
Well, yeah. No, it looked as phony as shit.
Okay.
But we liked the idea of having a Christmas tree.
You did.
It was more festive than anything. You know, Gentile holidays are much happier and enjoyable than Jewish holidays where you got to suffer even more. And so we actually had a Christmas tree that we would unfold the branches and put out every year.
That's fascinating. Well,
I think that's
I never knew that.
I think it's great because you probably loved it, right? I mean, it was Christmas. You saw Christmas all around you. At least you didn't feel like you couldn't have, you know, a colorful, happy holiday.
And the thing is, it's like, I think if you ask most Gentiles what Christmas means, they would have a hard time explaining.
Yeah. Oh, well, it means presents.
Yeah,
means presents.
Your father owned a hardware store and decided you had to have a Christmas.
Yeah, and
a Christmas tree.
But we also had a small metal menorah.
Okay.
So with candles. Right, so
and like
we used those same candles for the birthdays, too. And, yeah.
And your father owned a hardware store?
Yeah.
Yeah.
In Coney Island.
Yeah.
Oh, I love a man with a hardware store. Oh, did he have a Hanukkah belt? Oh. Yeah.
So favorite...
Save your hands, boys. You may need them later.
So we'll talk a little music quick. Favorite Christmas song growing up. And it could be a carol, or it could be like a song that was on the charts.
You know what I loved?
What do you love?
This is really fucked up. I love the Partridge Family Christmas album.
Oh, I have it. It's great.
I have it. I love the arrangements. Mm-hmm. I think it's like, it's really good. I really like it. That was a strange choice. She's like, jingle bells, hoo, jingle all the way, David Cassidy and Shirley Jones.
Not the Phil Spector Christmas album. No. That's pretty wonderful.
No, I love that too. And Mariah, as crazy as she is, Mariah Carey's first one is magnificent.
Now, Mariah Carey's out of her mind, isn't she?
She belongs in the nutty bin. Yes, I think she's crazy.
She's just out and out
batshit crazy.
I believe she is. I don't know this for a fact, but I've heard many things. She's nutty. What?
Go ahead.
But her Christmas album's pretty amazing.
About traditional stuff growing up? Like Feliz Navidad and...
No.
No.
No. No. I like the Barbra Streisand one when I was growing up. And of course, I love the Rankin Bass stuff. I love Santa Claus Is Coming to Town, and I love Rudolph, and We're on the Island of Misfit Toys. I love all that shit.
Gilbert impressed me by knowing the lyrics to We're on the Island of Misfit Toys.
Yeah. Island of Misfit Toys. There I do not. Oh, there I don't want to stay.
See, I don't even know that line. That's pretty good.
It was impressive.
And then it's the most wonderful day
of the year. Yeah.
When I was a kid, I was terrified of King Moonracer.
It was just, King Moonracer.
It was just a flying lion.
And he's like, he's a little gay too in it.
Yeah.
Hey, King I'm getting impatient. When do we get to the Bob Hope special?
Okay. Oh! I forgot to mention it on the major episode, but I sent it to Mario.
He'd never seen Jack Frost.
Jack Frost.
He was
106, and they made him up with icicles.
I swear to God, I don't think he knew his own name at that point.
And what about the wife who looks like a Rankin Bass?
Oh, Dolores Hope. Yes.
She looks like somebody carved her face.
And they've got a bunch of kids dancing around to overcompensate for the fact that Bob Hope is living dead.
And I'm going to tell you, there's nothing worse than children at Christmas.
Oh,
I can't bear them. I can't bear the children at Christmas. I don't like. I hate child actors. That's Dolores, right?
That's her.
She needed to sit this one out.
But oh, yeah, the poor thing.
She couldn't because Bob Hope was just a corpse on his feet. And I think, you know, they dress him up like Jack Frost with a pointed beard and pointed hat. And he's there like going, that's me. And
you can hear it now.
And I think it was Dolores' revenge for all the times that Bob Hope fucked around on her.
With Marilyn Maxwell.
Yeah, yeah. She wouldn't let him.
Right.
She wouldn't give him the satisfaction of him dying.
So she covered him in icicle makeup.
Yes,
And it looks like Rankin Bass designed his costume.
It's just gruesome.
He looks like the Winter Warlock.
I can't believe you'd never seen that.
No.
I had to send it to you.
Oh, my God.
And she's even worse. And then there's children. I can't. You know, I just went to Disney World, once I get there, I'm like, I'm going to have the greatest time. And then I see children, and I'm so resentful that they're here. It's like when I go see a Disney movie, and there's a kid in front of me. I always, like, lean forward and whisper in their ear, and I go, what are you doing here? Go home.
You still have that great mosaic in your dining room with the Disney, with the tiles?
That's by an artist named Russell.
That's great stuff.
Yeah, it's got Song of the South, and in the middle of it, it's all like all these riots during the Civil Rights Movement and the KKK. It's like
it's
kind of juxtaposes the two things. It's called Alabama Theater. It's a great piece.
Gil, what Christmas song do you actually enjoy besides the Rankin Bass ones? Bing's White Christmas? Do you like David Bowie and Bing doing the Little Drummer Boy together?
Oh, geez.
Any of those? How about Holly Jolly Christmas? Also from
Have a Holly Jolly Christmas.
Burl Ives, who named names,
it's
by the way.
It's the time of the year.
That's what they say.
Oh, by golly, have a Holly Jolly Christmas. This year.
Now, I think if Michael McDonald of the Doobie Brothers, if they ever remade Rudolph, Sam the Snowman in live action should be Michael McDonald because he's
Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year. I don't know what you been told, but have a cup of tea. Have a holly jolly Christmas. And when you walk down the street.
Yeah, that's my Michael McDonald.
I'm going to dial up a couple that I had Frank load up and tell me your memories of this one.
Have a pussy grabbing Christmas. It's the best time of the year. I don't know if you've been told, but grab some pussy this year.
These are some Christmas novelty songs you may remember. Frankie, you got the first one cued?
What is it?
Gil?
Yeah. Oh, I forget the name. It was Jingle Bells.
Yes,
obviously.
It's Jingle Bells by the Singing Dogs.
Oh, are you serious?
That's what it was.
You know
called.
About this?
I think I've heard this.
Oh, they play this every
popular
Christmas.
In the 70s.
Yeah, this is every Christmas. It's on the radio.
But where are the vocals?
Thanks, Frankie.
See, this just shows. I always bring up this song.
Yeah.
This to me shows, even back then, what they could do to singers. They could take a singer and change it. Like, and they can make a dog's barking sound like Jingle Bells.
They could.
So now.
They could, and they did. It was made in the 50s, but popular in the 70s.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
And this was before, like, auto-tune.
Before auto-tune.
Yeah.
I was going to say that. So what's the next one?
All right, Frankie, what's the second one? You got it? You guys know this? Mario?
Dominic the Donkey?
Hey! It's Dominic the Donkey.
Jiggity jig. Italian fucking donkey.
Oh. La, la,
oh.
La, 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 la,
I just
la,
see all old la, Italian women with mustaches and cherry cloth robes dancing around. It's horrifying. I heard this for the first time in Newport, Rhode Island on the radio. I didn't even know it existed.
Lou Monte.
When did this was the 60s?
1960, December 1960.
Jiggity jig. I mean, you know.
Re-released in 2011 for some strange reason.
The Italians had the most hilarious, like, jiggity jig. Like, they go into a bank in the 50s, and to get the attention of the teller, they go, hi-ho. I mean, what the
fuck remember,
is that?
Do you remember Lou Monte, Gil?
Oh, yeah.
Peppino the Italian Mouse.
Yes.
He did Peppino.
He had hit records.
And
He was a big deal.
See, I always confused Peppino the Italian mouse and Topo Gigio. They were different, though, right?
Yeah, Peppino was Italian. I guess Topo Gigio was Italian, too.
Did they sue each other? I mean,
on
they're kind
Roulette
of similar.
Records, the Ma Bone record label that Tommy James had. The
Wow.
Roulette was Ma Bone?
Yeah.
Oh,
how about this one, Frankie?
Oh, I remember this.
Yep. You know the actor? The famous actor who's singing this as a child?
It's a boy?
Yeah, it's a boy.
Are you sure?
See if I stumped you, boys.
Is it Ron Howard?
You know this actor?
He was the president of SAG.
Barry Gordon.
No, Barry Gordon. Wow.
He was on Fish with Abe Vigoda. You know Barry Gordon, Gil?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Child actor.
I remember that. But.
Yeah.
Now, wasn't Barry Gordon in a movie with Bobby Darin?
He may have been.
I think it was a movie where Bobby Darin was like an American Nazi.
Was it Point? What was it?
A Pressure Point?
Pressure Point?
Maybe.
We can put that out to our listeners. Barry Gordon was on the sitcom Fish.
And
he did a lot of work.
He played Bobby Darin as a kid in the movie.
Very good.
Wow.
I did not know that. We'll put that out to our listeners if you know the movie with Barry Gordon.
Nothing.
Meanwhile, our listeners told us there were at least two other Blofelds in the James Bond movies.
That's right. Yes. Charles Gray, I think, was Blofeld, and somebody else. I got a couple more here you guys might remember. These are novelty songs, Christmas novelty songs.
I love those 007 movies. Blowfinger was my favorite.
Okay, Frankie. Gil will spot it.
The news had come out in the first world war. Snoopy.
It's Snoopy's Christmas.
Oh,
Snoopy.
Yeah.
By the Royal Guardsman.
I remember this, too. Ignored all of his
men. Yeah.
I love the Charlie Brown Christmas special. It's one of the greats. I'm dancing!
This song was huge for some reason.
It was.
Yeah.
I have the album.
In New Zealand.
Really?
It is the biggest selling single in the history of New Zealand.
Wow.
Yeah.
I think I had this whole album.
The Royal Guardsman, 1967. Thanks, Frankie.
Frankie, that was fantastic.
And one last one. Do you have any memories of these?
That I absolutely do. I just remember having that album.
Okay.
And I remember that I think the Red Baron was on the cover of it.
Well, there was another Snoopy single. There was Snoopy versus the Red Baron first, and then this was the Christmas.
And then there was that song that I guess they wanted to avoid being sued, so that was Hold On Sloopy.
Hold On Sloopy by the McCoys.
Yeah.
Yeah. Rick Derringer.
Sloopy, hang on.
Hang on, Sloopy.
Yeah, I remember that.
We got one more novelty song.
Let's
go ahead, Frankie.
One
this one, of course, is iconic.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
All right, you chipmunks. Ready to sing your song?
I have this album, too.
Okay, Simon.
Okay.
Okay, Theodore.
David Seville.
Okay, Alvin. Alvin. Alvin!
Listen to those chipmunk harmonies. Oh,
1958. Yeah. Won 3 Grammys.
It won 3 Grammys?
Yes, it did. The late Ross Bagdasarian, also known as David Seville. Yeah, the chipmunk song.
I remember that, too. I had that album, too.
Yeah.
I like the chipmunks. I don't know why, though. Why did I? At least they're in tune. At least they're.
But then they made that movie recently.
Awful.
That was painful.
Horrible.
Awful.
Horrible.
I agree. They did two of them, didn't they?
I guess so.
Yeah. Did you listen to Christmas music as a kid?
Oh, I couldn't avoid it.
Yeah, but this kind of stuff, like the kind of stuff that charted, like pop songs and novelty songs.
Yeah, I remember. I'd hear it. Well, I'd hear it all the time on the radio. You can't avoid it.
Do you hate Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer as much as I do?
Can I tell you one of my favorite recent Christmas albums? It's Kelly Clarkson's. Have you heard it?
I heard that was good.
It's brilliant. In fact, I opened with Wrapped in Red, which is one of the songs she does on the album, and it's actually the title song for my concert in Fort Lauderdale. And it's really produced brilliantly. It's a lot of original stuff, and she does a rocking version of Run Run Rudolph, and she does Blue Christmas, but then she does some original stuff. Well, Michael McDonald has a great Christmas album too.
I like Rocking Around the Christmas Tree myself.
Oh, I love Rocking Around.
Yeah.
The Christmas Tree. Yeah. Happy.
That's a favorite.
Later we'll have some fucking fun. I like that.
Now,
that was
more
Brenda
importantly.
Lee.
Brenda Lee. More importantly, Kelly Clarkson's fat now, isn't she?
She's heavy now. Yeah. Well, she had a baby and but she's like, she goes up and down, but I think she's like, fuck it. This is what I look like.
This is what we established. Kelly Clarkson's fat and Mariah Carey's out of her mind.
Yes.
Okay.
But Kelly Clarkson.
Have a wonderful Christmas.
But Kelly Clarkson's got that voice.
She's talented.
I have a question. What about Bob Dylan's Christmas album? Have you ever heard that?
Oh. Jiggabidge.
But it's beautifully orchestrated too. It's like there's a lot of.
Yes, it's lush.
It's lush. And then he's like, he keeps it good, he keeps it good, it good, we come day to be. It's so brutal. Oh, do you hear what I hear? Apparently not.
We're on the island of misfit toys. Jolly, jolly Christmas.
You used to do Dylan in your act.
Yeah.
Dylan having a conversation with Floyd the Barber.
Oh, yeah, I still do. I never throw anything away.
Don't throw it away. Yes.
He still does it.
Hello, Floyd. Hello, Floyd.
Howard McNear.
That's hilarious.
That's fantastic.
Oh, my
fantastic.
God.
The first time I ever saw him, I fell madly in love with him. So we'll go out on this, since this was music-themed. I know you both know this one.
Oh,
Gilbert said, make sure you give me the lyrics.
And
Mario will know them by heart. Pro that he is.
And by the way, I'm doing a Christmas show with my husband.
Yes,
the cutting
talk
room.
About it, my
it's
friend.
At the cutting room.
Your
Sunday.
Husband?
My husband.
God, you sound like a faggot or something.
Shut the fuck up, I eat pussy. I eat a lot of pussy. Look at my fucking mouth. It looks like a fucking glazed donut. fuck you, Gilbert. Fuck you. Fuck you, fag.
Why do you have to work blue at the holidays?
I've got to. My husband and I, my husband, Sid Lufton. No, my husband, Jerry
David
Dixon and
Gesh.
I. My husband, David Gish. David's kisses seem filled with rainbow pride.
The insanely talented Jerry. And
Jerry Dixon,
the three of us just had the pleasure of working together.
We did. We wrote a great election song.
We did, and then the three of us cried.
And
we wept.
We sure did.
We wept in
the
hallway.
It was horrifying. That was such a
weird
night.
But that was a fun day.
But we had, we're doing, the cutting room, Sunday at 8:30. The 18th.
What is the show? What happens?
It's basically the holiday edition of the show that we did at Lincoln Center in February. It's just us singing and talking about our relationship. We don't really talk about, like, the chronological order of our relationship.
Is Jerry the accompanist?
No, we got a full band.
You got a full band.
Yeah, and it's just,
Sunday night?
Sunday night the 18th. It's really good.
Can I still get a ticket?
Yes.
Oh, well,
yes.
I think I will
yes,
grab the missus.
You should come.
We will come.
Can
Gilbert come and join in on the Island of Misfit Toys?
Yes, you can. Cuttingroom.com. There are no comps. Fuck you. I have to pay for six tickets for my
cutting
family.
Cutting room in here in Manhattan.
Yes.
And what else is coming up for you, Mr. Cantona? Perhaps another one-man show.
I'm working on it. I think I'm going to try to go to Chicago with it first and then come in here. Maybe in the spring or the summer, go to Chicago.
Okay.
And it's going to be huge. Believe me, it's huge.
And this will be up Thursday, and we will tell our listeners that following this mini-episode, Mario has, we had the pleasure of having Mario for a full episode, which will be up Monday.
I would never even just accept a mini-episode. I would feel slighted. I needed both.
Never do that to you. So we're going to go out on this.
All right.
And I thought that maybe Tony Curtis and Ms. Betty Davis.
Okay. All right. After the stroke before?
I would insist on nothing less.
Yeah. All right.
So do
Maestro Verderosa.
Go ahead.
I really can't stay.
But maybe it's cold outside.
I've got to go away.
But maybe it's cold outside.
This evening has been.
Been hoping you'd drop
so
in.
So very nice.
I'll hold your hands like they're just like ice.
My mother will start to worry.
Beautiful watch you're
My
wearing.
My father will be pacing the floor.
Listen to the fireplace
so
roar.
So I really better scurry.
Beautiful, please don't hurry.
Well, maybe just a half a drink more.
Put some records on while
the
I pour.
The neighbors might think.
Baby, it's cold
say
outside.
What is in this drink?
No cabs to be had
I
out there.
I wish I knew how.
Your eyes are like
to
starlight now.
Break this spell.
I'll take your hat. Your hair looks swell.
No, 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 no.
Mind if I move closer?
At least I'm going to say I tried.
What's the sense of hurting my pride?
I really can't stay.
Baby, don't hold out.
Baby, it's cold outside.
Baby, it's cold outside.
Yes, it really is. My tits are very erect. Wait, second verse. I simply must go.
Baby, it's cold outside.
The answer is no.
Wait, oh. Wait
this
a minute,
David. Welcome has
oh,
been.
Baby, it's cold outside.
So nice and warm.
Oh, look at the windows at the store.
My sister will be suspicious.
Gosh, your lips look delicious.
My brother will be there at the door.
Waves upon a tropical
My
shore.
My maiden aunt's mind is vicious.
Gosh, your lips are delicious.
Well, maybe just a cigarette more. I've got to
Never
get
a blizzard before. But baby, you'll freeze
Say,
out there.
Say, lend me your comb. You
It's
really...
up to your knees out there.
I'm on my knees. You
I
really
thrill
have the
when you touch my head.
Oh, but don't you see? There's bound
How
to
can
be
can you
talk
do
tomorrow.
This thing to me?
At least they'll
Think
be plenty
of my lifelong sorrow.
I really can't stay.
If you caught pneumonia
but
and died.
Baby, it's cold.
Get over all doubt. Baby, it's cold
oh,
outside.
My, you were 10 lines behind. Totally and utterly unprofessional. It was like working with Faye Dunaway
oh,
again.
Oh, shut up, you fucking bitch.
Oh, you are. Don't you dare call me a bitch.
Oh, half Mario. Of your face is paralyzed.
Where is my mouth? I cannot find my mouth.
Why do you still wear miniskirts?
Well,
it's disgusting.
Patrick Kelly made this miniskirt for me. It has buttons all over it. Oh, yes.
You
oh.
weigh 2.5 pounds
well,
now.
Well, because I smoke, I don't eat potato chips and almond croissants like you do.
You have skeletal legs.
Yes, I do. But the legs are the last to go. Mine are being amputated next week.
I think the mini episode might be better. You'll hear both.
Oh, Mario, you're the best.
Thank you, boys. I
Thank
really appreciate
you.
It. Happy holidays, Merry
happy
Christmas,
holidays.
Happy New Year, and
we'll see you at the cutting
we'll
room.
See cutting room Sunday night. Me and Jerry doing
and,
our Christmas
and
show.
Me and Mario will be in dinner theater performing The Jew and the Fae.
Oh, yes. And then in repertory with The Man That Came to Dinner.
Well, I'm Gilbert Gottfried. This has been Gilbert Gottfried's Gilbert and Frank's Amazing Colossal Obsessions with my co-host, Frank Santopadre.
He finally got
Frank
his name title.
Thank
huh?
you,
That's
Frank Verderosa.
Frank Verderosa, our engineer at Nutmeg.
Three Italians and a Jew. This is the greatest Christmas ever.
Just beat the crap out of him.
let's fucking kick his ass.
And our guest was once again Mario Canto.
Thank you, boys. Good evening. I wish all of my listeners a very happy holidays.
Here we go.